this morning, and when I called Cookie, she said, "You know that's 41 verses." And I said, "Yes, I do." And she says, "I think I can do it." And I said, "I know you can." So thank you, Miss Cookie, for reading our scripture this morning. This is God's word for his people this morning. We can take these words and we can make many metaphors about what the scripture is telling us this morning. But the questions that we want to ask ourselves this morning in reference to this text about, you know, I had the kids wearing their little things this morning and walking. Are there things within this world that we live in that we maybe are blind to, that we should open our eyes to? And this goes in our way of thought. Are we blind in our thinking? Have we thought through our own faith journeys? Where have we seen God show up in our lives and in the lives of the world? In today's text, we see God heal a blind man who had been blind for many years. But this is not what the text is speaking about. As I talked about last week, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, when he lived and when he walked into this world, he wanted us to love him not because of what he could do for us. Jesus did not want to be known as a magician. Okay? Da-da-da! Jesus! That was not why Jesus was brought into this world. Jesus was brought in as the light of the world to restore darkness, not to those that were only physically blind, but those that are spiritually blind, those that may be emotionally blind. And as we sit here in this church this morning, as I have said, we are the light of the world, as people of the risen Savior. So what is our call as people of the risen Savior today? Are we to bring light into the world for those that are living in darkness? In this morning's Sunday school class, we talked about encouragement and getting through the rough times as Christians. Is there a time in our life, even as followers of Christ, when we may feel discouraged, where we may feel distant from God? How do we go through the rough times, and how do we go through the blind times in our world, and how do we minister and love those that may be feeling blind this morning? What do we do? And how are we to be encouragers as this light of the world? This morning's message is broken down into 4 points. Sin at the beginning and sin at the end. Many believe that the blind man to be a sinner because he was blind. And if it wasn't his sin, it must have been his parents' sin. Jesus must have been a sinner because he healed on the Sabbath. And finally, one is a sinner when they have sight of Jesus Christ within them and they refuse to acknowledge it. You see, when Jesus did this initial healing, it had to be sin. This man was blind because there had to be sin here. It was either his sin, his parents' sin. It was because Jesus, how dare Jesus heal on the Sabbath? Can you believe that? You're not supposed to work on the Sabbath, but I will tell you this for true. When Tim Polly gets home, there's going to be floor mopping, there's going to be vacuuming, there's going to be bed making, there's going to be work on the Sabbath. Because you want to know why? Because there's going to be a lady coming home before the Sabbath is over. It wasn't about the sin. See, this man was born sinless. It said he was blind from birth. Beloved, as God writes our stories, we must open all our eyes and share the special sight that God has given us through the special gifts, but most of all, by the love that Jesus Christ has given each and every one of us. Let's see. I still have a few left. Let's see. How do you bring light into the world, Mr. Father Gill? What's your gift and talent? By flipping a switch. Could it also be by flipping a camera shutter?
are the light of the world.
So let me ask you this.
How are you an encourager? How are you the light of the world? Do you visit people? Do you tell them that the church loves them and that God loves them? Do you bring them the Lord's people? You are the light of the world. All right, let me thank you. Who else can we talk to? Grab word. How are you an encourager? And how do you bring the light into the world? Are you the idea of that?
Yeah.
All right. You always have that energy and that freshness.
Okay.
It's never been serious between me, right?
Right.
You are the light of the world. Keep sharpening the saw. All right, let me think here. How are you the light and encourager of the world?
How are we the encouragers of the world, and what is Christ asking us to do this morning? So, secondly, we know that it's not about sin, but it's about encouragement and the love of Jesus Christ. And now we can be that light in the world to others. Secondly, knowing how to live and to share the word no in our life stories. Not N-O, but K-N-O-W. To know. Our life stories are ones in which we must share our knowledge of Christ in our individual and group ministries. You see, our text this morning shows the blind man not knowing Jesus and the Pharisees not knowing or believing Jesus. Beloved, we must be people of shared knowledge and shared faith. One, our life stories must be ones in which knowledge in Christ is lived and increased by and through our faith as well as our faith witness. When we live lives of Christian faith, it leads to worship. When this occurs in our lives, we have a knowledge that becomes instructive to those that are spiritually blind. But we must be careful to live lives not like those Pharisees, in which they believed they knew it all and were unwilling to learn.
They knew it all, but were unwilling to learn. When was the last time we sat down with our texts? My encouragement to you this week is the text that we're studying and talking about this morning. Make that your text of the week. Take it home. Look at it. Delve into it. Dive into it. Parse words. What is it saying for your life as you go out within yourselves, with your families, and loving and living in this world that we live in? Beloved, we could spend hours and days spreading the discouraging news. Amen? What's wrong with this world? What is wrong with this world? This, that, and the other thing. But beloved, what is right with the world is what we need to be encouraged of the good news. How often do people have the privilege and the honor and the blessing and the promise to share good news? You are encouragers. You are light bearers for a world that is in. We must know as to live. So we've talked about sin, and we've talked about knowing. Thirdly, our life story is one in which we can not be moved in our faith. In our text, the Pharisees try to push the blind man away from his faith in Christ. But what they were doing, Lord, I love you, and I love your plan for this.
were trying to push this blind man away from Christ. They said, this guy is a sinner. He healed on the Sabbath. He must be a sinner. What did they end up doing? They pushed him closer to Christ. Are there people in this world today that try to discourage you in your faith? That try to push you away from Jesus? Brothers and sisters, this is where we delve closer and closer, and we live in the Word of God, in the love of God, in the promise of God. Lord, you can't take away my joy because you gave it to me. Earth, you cannot take away my happiness. A host of all your wealth. They cannot take away your salvation. You know, that's something that the world can never take away. Is your salvation. You want to know why? Because God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. That whosoever believeth in him, come on, shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Beloved, this is the promise of God's word. This is why Jesus walked on this earth. It wasn't to heal blind men. It wasn't as the role of a general or a magician. It was the role as Jesus Christ, as the light to this world. That it will never live in darkness as long as Jesus Christ lived and died and was resurrected for us. Did you notice one thing this morning? It was a bit dark when we began to worship this morning. Look at us. Thanks be to God for the light of the world.
So, we cannot be moved in our faith. Fourthly, our life story is one in which Jesus is present at the right time and in the right place. Can anybody relate to this? Has Jesus been present at the right time and in the right place for you? And how has this been done? Has Jesus had somebody come across your path just when you needed them? Who has been your encourager? And the question that I posed this morning, how will Jesus put each and every one of us in the right place and in the right time to be that encourager that that person so desperately needs? Have you worked with somebody, loved upon somebody, and they said, you know, I'm so needy today. I was praying for this morning. Thank you, because you all are that light of the world, that encouraging love that God calls to be there at the right time and at the right place. And you want to know why, how it is the right time and the right place? Because God said it is. You don't have to worry about the timing. You don't have to worry about the place. You have to just be willing, because God will put you there in the right time and the right place to do miraculous and wonderful things. And it won't be in the role of a magician out of hand, but rather through the light and the love of Jesus Christ.
Our life stories, as I said, may all read differently.
Each one of us is on a different journey through Christ. Christ is sending us down different roads that lead to the same location. But there's one thing that we can count on as followers of Christ, as the light of Christ in the world.
H-O-P-E. God has given us hope. And as the light of the world, as the encouragers, God has given you the hope for yourself, for your children, your family, and for the world that you live in. Did you know that? You are people of hope. So, my question to you this morning, and heck with all that other stuff in there.
How is God going to make you the hope this week? I want you to think about that. H-O-P-E, and how will I live it this week? You cannot tell me that you don't know somebody that is not in need of encouragement. Somebody that doesn't need Dwight, hey, I love you. And God loves you.
This is the encouragement. You're a teacher. How many of your kids need encouragement? You see it every day. How many of our little guys and gals need encouragement? You're doing a great job. We're so proud of you. It is easier to lift up and shine God's beaming light on people than it is to discourage them and make them feel bad. So in conclusion, what did this blind man get with his sight? What did Christ give him? Hope over lives, hope for a future, and the hope that there is nothing that anybody can say or that anybody can do that can take Jesus Christ. Why? Because we have hope, and we have the promise of God. We were born, but when we know Jesus Christ, we were given sight. And may we all go forward sharing that sight and sharing that hope for the world ever more and more and more in need. This is what the text is telling us. Hope in the sight of Christ, in the presence of Christ, and the promise of Christ. This is God's word to the people.
As we sing our close.